Hi, I'm Trina White with Newfoundland Power. The following video is intended to raise your electrical hazard awareness when working in proximity of both overhead and underground power lines. The video's primary focus is on construction companies, construction workers, and property owners who work in close proximity to energized power lines.
Before we begin, however, it is important to point out that there are several electric utility companies of varying sizes with operations in Newfoundland and Labrador. Newfoundland Power is the primary distributor of electricity in the province. Newfoundland Power supplies 90% of residential and commercial electricity service on the island portion and services in excess of 271,000 customers. Prior to commencing work around energized power lines, it is necessary for you to know which electric utility you may need to contact. The electric utility with lines and equipment at the location you intend to conduct work can provide you with important information regarding any overhead and underground power lines in your work area. The Newfoundland Occupational Health and Safety Regulation, Section 498, states that for minimum clearance, high voltage equipment and conductors, a worker shall not cause or permit material to be piled, stored or handled, a scaffold to be erected or dismantled, or mobile crane, boom truck or similar equipment to operate in an area where overhead or underground conductors are located that are capable of energizing the material, mobile equipment, or its load unless the employer has obtained in writing the voltage and minimum clearance distance required by the power utility. Where the written clearance referred to in subsection 1 is unavailable from the power utility, a minimum 5.5 meters shall be maintained. Contact your electric utility provider for information regarding minimum safe distances prior to commencing any work activity near energized power lines. By law, you must arrange an energized power line permit if the 5.5 meters clearance to high voltage lines and equipment cannot be maintained. The electric utility will also provide information on the minimum distances that must be maintained from these lines or equipment during the work. If the minimum distance cannot be maintained, the utility may be able to provide an alternate method to complete the work safely. If you see a down pole or power line, stay back a minimum of 10 meters or 30 feet. 30 meters or 90 feet is safer. If you intend to do any work around energized power lines, please contact the electric utility that services your area. If the work is located in an area where the lines and equipment is owned by Newfoundland Power, you can contact us by calling 1-800-663-2802. In addition to direct contact with an energized power line or utility equipment, there are two additional ways that severe injury or death may occur. These are known as step potential and touch potential. Both of these hazards have resulted in serious injuries and death to workers who have been involved in power line contacts in the past. When an energized power line is down, lying on the ground, or in contact with a piece of equipment, the current flows from the line to the earth. This current flow creates a difference in potential at and around this entry point. The current flow can result in a gradient of different potentials that spread outward across the surface of the ground for an area of 10 meters or more. When your feet are situated between two different electrical voltage zones, this is known as step potential. For example, if one foot is located in a voltage zone of 10,000 volts and the other foot is located in a voltage of 6,000 volts, then the potential difference of 4,000 volts causes current to flow through your body. Because of step potential, all workers must stay back 10 meters or more from down power lines or any equipment that is in contact with energized lines or electrical equipment. You must also warn others to do the same as the area is not electrically safe. You must not approach the area until the electric utility has come to the site and has made the area electrically safe. Touch potential is when your body becomes the path for electricity to flow to the ground when touching an energized object or power line. By creating this path for current to flow through your body, this may result in serious injury or death. It is important to remember that electricity travels at approximately the speed of light. Just as with step potential, Once contact is made with an energized power line or equipment, the ground around the point of contact, for some distance, will become and remain energized. Let's look at what happens when a piece of equipment contacts an energized power line. Electricity will take all paths to ground, and almost anything can be a conductor. In this case, the path to ground was completed through the boom, the outriggers, the pads, and the tires. Once contact was made, the path to ground was established. Being on the truck, the driver was not part of the electrical circuit as the rubber tires provided a level of protection to the operator. He correctly decides to remain on the truck and called the utility for assistance in making the area electrically safe. Had he stepped off, injury or death may have occurred because of step potential. The operator of the equipment should only attempt to exit energized equipment if they're in an immediate life-threatening situation, such as fire. If they have to leave and to avoid step potential, they should exit the vehicle by jumping clear and landing with their feet together without stumbling. Never contact the ground and the equipment at the same time. Their entire body must clear the equipment. Keep the feet together and hop or shuffle a safe distance away. This safe distance is always 10 meters or more. Remember, if at all possible, the safest place is to remain with the equipment until the electric utility arrives on scene and makes the area electrically safe. If there is no immediate risk, have all workers remain back 10 meters or more, call 911 and inform them there is an electrical contact. Wait until the electric utility has come to the site and made the area electrically safe before exiting the vehicle. If someone has received an electrical shock, do not approach or touch them if they are still in contact with the source of the power or you believe the electricity is still present. It is possible that the power may come back on at any time and without warning. Again, you must stay back and warn others to stay away until the electric utility has come to the site and made the area electrically safe. Working near power lines is dangerous. However, when properly planned and executed, it can be completely safe. Before working near energized power lines, a documented hazard assessment must be completed. The hazard assessment must include all workers involved in the work and must be communicated to any additional workers who may arrive after the work has started. The hazard assessment needs to take into consideration all power lines and electrical equipment in and around the work area, both overhead and underground. The work needs to be well planned and workers need to be knowledgeable in the tasks they are to perform. Workers must also know of the regulations required by law to ensure the work is conducted safely when working around electrical lines and equipment. Every day, there are numerous pieces of equipment being operated by contractors and private citizens that have the possibility of contacting energized power lines. This equipment may include, but is not limited to, dump trucks, excavators, boom trucks, cranes, loaders, backhoes, tractor trailers, delivery trucks, snow plows, waste disposal trucks, concrete trucks, and pumpers. The Newfoundland Occupational Health and Safety Regulations, Section 483, states, a person shall not operate a mobile crane, boom truck, or similar equipment that has the capacity of encroaching on a power line without having first completed a safety training program on power line hazards required by the Commission. Workers that use equipment such as the following should also be aware of any power lines in their work area: personal lifts, scaffolding, ladders, roofing lift equipment, surveyor's rods, farming equipment, or any work that includes tools and equipment that has the ability to contact energized power lines and equipment. Operators of equipment with the ability of contacting power lines must have knowledge of the minimum approach distance that must be maintained to any lines and equipment present in the work zone. They must make certain they have a method in place to ensure this distance is maintained. Operators of heavy equipment have the additional responsibility to ensure the safety of workers who are in or may enter the work zone of the equipment they are operating. Workers must also take added precautions when working with materials that easily conduct electricity, such as scaffolding, metal piping, guard railing, ladders, rebar, and other similar items. Trucks with their dump raised, excavators with an elevated boom, or any equipment that has the possibility of touching power lines are at high risk of making contact. When working near overhead power lines, always make sure you maintain the safe working distance of 5.5 meters or more from high voltage lines and equipment. If this distance cannot be maintained, an energized power line permit, as previously mentioned, from the electric utility is required. Equipment operators must always be diligent and keep a sharp lookout. Better still, when working near high voltage power lines and equipment, have a dedicated observer acting as a guide. In this case, we see a dump truck beginning to back under some overhead lines. As the operator is working alone, the driver correctly stops the truck ahead of the lines, gets out, and observes the position of the equipment. By conducting a site hazard assessment, the operator will have a clear understanding of the height of the lines, as well as how close he can approach if he needs to raise the dump. If you intend to move or transport any load with a restricted height limit along any public road, you may be required to obtain a permit from the Department of Transportation and Works. Your electric utility provider must also be contacted in advance of the move to determine if an escort is required. Remember, always plan the work and work the plan. Remember, not all energized power lines are overhead. In addition to any overhead lines in your work zone, there could also be underground power lines present. Contact with an underground energized line or piece of electrical equipment can also result in immediate severe injury or even death. Today, many lines in residential and commercial areas are located underground. Workers should always be aware of the location of underground lines and take measures to avoid contact. Underground power lines present special hazards when any excavation or drilling is required. You must contact the electric utility and arrange an underground locate in advance of the work. The location of any buried power or utility line must be established before any work is commenced. Once again, a hazard assessment should be undertaken and a work plan should be developed. Underground lines are often, but not always, protected with a warning marker. When digging, caution tape, conduit, or other materials such as concrete, wooden planking, or sand may be encountered. If you encounter any of these items when digging, stop work immediately and contact your electric utility provider before continuing. You need to be aware that warning signs may not always be there. There may be no indication or record of a buried line in the area in which you may be working. Also, warning signs may be incorrectly marked or may have been moved or removed over time. It's your responsibility to check with your electric utility provider to make sure the area is safe and free of energized lines before commencing any work. Trees are a good conductor of high voltage electricity. If contact is made, the path to ground could be through you. Step and touch potential hazards will exist. Trimming or felling of trees near power lines should be avoided. When trimming or felling trees, the following must be observed. Never fall a tree that is in a power line corridor. Never fall a tree or trim branches that have the potential to contact overhead lines if control is lost. Tree trimming or felling of trees with the potential of contacting high voltage power lines must be conducted by a qualified utility arborist. Contact your electric utility provider if you have questions concerning tree trimming or felling in proximity of overhead lines. If a tree does contact a line or piece of electrical equipment, you must stay back 10 meters and also warn others to stay back. Contact the electric utility. They will come and make the area electrically safe. When erecting a scaffold, ladders, or any elevated equipment, the required 5.5 meters distance must be maintained from any high voltage energized lines. This is a requirement not only for contractors, but also for private citizens performing maintenance and construction activities around their own property. An energized power line permit is required if the 5.5 meters clearance cannot be maintained from any high voltage lines or equipment. Do not proceed without contacting the electric utility if the 5.5 meter clearance to high voltage lines or equipment is not possible. If you are unsure of the voltage level or if you have any questions concerning power lines and equipment in proximity to your work zone, please contact your electric service provider. If a safe distance cannot be maintained, alternate arrangements might have to be made to make the area electrically safe before work can begin. Let's take the time for a final review. Working around, near, or under energized power lines requires training, knowledge, caution, and common sense. Know the regulations and work carefully. When working around energized power lines, always observe the following. Survey the site to locate any overhead or underground power lines. Obtain an underground locate by the electric utility for any buried lines that might be in the work area. Arrange for an energized power line permit if required. Conduct a hazard assessment and communicate it with all workers involved in the work. Follow the instructions provided by the electric utility. Show others in the work zone the location of any power lines. When moving or positioning equipment, use a dedicated observer and maintain visual contact. Warn others of any dangers. Develop an emergency response plan as part of the hazard assessment and follow it if required. You have a right and a responsibility to arrive safely back home at the end of your shift. When dealing with high voltage electricity, it only takes that one split second to change your life forever. After all, there are others wanting for you to come home safe.